I wanted to show you how to use the pan watercolors on your small paper to just create a quick little landscape study, creating a background, middle ground, and foreground. You must start with a wet brush, and you must wake up the colors so that there is a slight puddle of water in the colors. You don't want to dig around into them. You're not scooping up these paints. You're not poking at them. You're simply just kind of waking them up with water. Watercolors need water to work. I would recommend starting with your background first and moving down towards your foreground, since the foreground will overlap the middle ground and the middle ground will be in front of the background. So I'm going to start with my sky first. And I've been waking up some warm colors, but we just talked about how colors will get cooler as they go back in the distance. Now you certainly can create a warm color sky, but I'm going to do a cool one. And you see, I'm just kind of waking up all my colors so they're ready for me, cleaning my brush off between every color. And I actually am going to clean my brush off completely and just paint with water at the top of my paper. Just water, getting it nice and wet. Then I'm going to use my blue and go over with just blue. Now when your paper gets wet, it does appear a little grayish because it's not watercolor paper, it's just drawing paper. But that doesn't mean that you can't create some of these cool effects. You see how those blues are kind of blending into one another? I'm not scrubbing really hard with my brush. I am simply going back and forth. You don't have to go all the way to the edge of your paper. You can stop a little bit, and then you can kind of just see what happens. Let the watercolor do its own kind of blending with other colors. Well, now that I'm done with my sky, I think I'm ready to do something with the middle ground, and I'm going to choose this green color. And I might make a crisp line here without painting with water first, and maybe start warming up some of that greenish color with this lovely orange, and even waking up this burnt sienna color. I might add both of those to them. Using your water, keeping enough water and paint on your brush all the time. Do you see I'm blending those colors together? I'm not really making stripes on my paper. I'm letting the colors combine without mixing them all together. Bring this down a little bit more. My paper is wrinkling here a little bit because I have it very wet. And maybe some of this orange here. So there is my middle ground, and absolutely it's okay for you to use this mixing palette to see what a color looked like. So I wasn't sure what was that was going to look like, but I really do like what's happening there. And then I think I'd like to just kind of bring this across this way. It's a very bright color, and if your colors aren't looking bright enough on your paper, you might just need to add more of the color on your brush. Test it out over here. This is going to be my foreground, so I'm going to go a little darker. I might even wake up the brown. Stay away from that black until the very, very end, until you absolutely need something that dark. We will be adding details next week, but just not today. Today is just about getting colors on your paper. I'm not quite sure what that blue is going to look like. I think I'm going to just stick with my warm colors here. I might mix a little red into this one here. Just finish that across. So now I can see my sky. I did leave an area of white there because as the sky comes down closer to the horizon, it will be getting lighter. And I'm just gonna make this a little, ooh, I like that, a little darker for my foreground. And that's gonna be like a little hill coming right in front of me. And the warm colors are going back and getting cooler. I am done with this. The more I play with this, the more the paper is going to just get exhausted and tired. The more your colors are going to start getting a little muddy and not so bright. So if you finish and you have time left in class, you can do another one.